So I'm in the process of making upgrades to my stream and YouTube content, which means upgrades to my stream room, new camera gear, and new audio gear. And I've been testing a few things out. And while testing, a great opportunity came up to make a video for all of you out there about proper sound dampening, or soundproofing, or sound absorption, whichever term you like to use. They're pretty much all the same. And with proper sound dampening, you can really increase the clarity, the richness, the cleanness of your vocals during your live stream and YouTube content. And I want to show you how to do it, plus some cheap solutions that you can introduce right at the end of this video that will really help your live streams and YouTube content. Let's go.
Time to fall in line, soldier, and upgrade your stream with the brand new Army Series package from Owned. With this beautiful overlay package, you get great graphics, alerts, and more. Want to save even more money? Make sure you use the links down below in the video description and visit Owned.tv to see if they have any awesome coupons going on. Make sure you take your stream to the next level with Owned.
Hey, what is up, all you awesome streamers out there? Wild for Games here to make sure your content becomes bigger and better. If this is your first time here, you need help with tips, tricks, or how-tos, I'm the perfect man for you. Make sure you hit that big red subscribe button down below and tick that bell so you know when my videos go live for you. When it comes down to knocking down all the sounds you don't want within your stream room or studio setup, you generally have three options that are not software-based. You have soundproofing, sound dampening, and sound absorption. And yeah, these technically are all different, but since you're not Mr. Wizard, nor will you get that reference, we're basically gonna generalize it to where we're trying to dissipate or trap the sound waves so that way they don't have a chance to bounce off a surface and feed back into our microphone for our broadcast or content. And if we can achieve this, we're gonna get cleaner, crisper, and richer vocals in our broadcast and content. That's all we're trying to achieve. And if that sounds a little confusing, let me just show you an example so that way we're all on the same page. This is how my voice sounds with minimal sound dampening. In fact, the only dampening I really have is the curtain that's behind me and the floor that is in my stream room is carpeted. But my microphone is give or take about 14 inches away from my face, and I'm about 3 to 4 feet away from a wall. In fact, I'm kind of more or less slammed into a corner, so which is why you hear my voice the way that it is. My voice still sounds clear, but it's not as clear as it could be if I added sound dampening. In fact, it'd be a lot crisper, cleaner, and richer. Now, let me show you what it sounds like with added dampening.
Hello, do I sound better now? Hopefully I do. All right, first things first, please excuse the Frankenstein lighting. This is only for the example of audio. Currently, I'm speaking into some blackout curtains, which really absorb a lot of sound. To the sides of those on some walls is some acoustic paneling and some artwork. And then behind me off to the sides, you probably can't see it, is some more acoustic paneling scattered around. And yeah, I'm still in the same stream room and it has carpet on the floor. So all those things really add for a richer tone in my voice because the sound dampening is taking away all of the excess sound that I don't want feeding back into my microphone.
See how much of a difference there is when you add proper sound dampening or sound absorption material within your stream room or studio setup? It really does help. It's gonna help so much because when somebody clicks into your content or your stream, right off the bat, something within their ears is gonna be just entranced with your voice because it's gonna sound cleaner, crisper, and richer compared to all the other streams at your concurrent value. This is a great way to stand out. Now that I've educated you on the why sound dampening is important, let me educate you on the how. In fact, I'm gonna educate you on how to add sound dampening to your room for cheap. Hey, do you have hardwood floors or maybe tile? You can easily get yourself a cheap throw rug. This will increase the sound dampening exponentially within your room. Perhaps you have plank walls in your room. You can put up sound blankets. Sound blankets too expensive for you? You can use some cheap towels or beach towels to really knock down the sound. If you end up going the towel route, there are some awesome sound panels that you can make. Simply type in on YouTube, DIY sound panel, and you'll get a bunch of different tutorials, and they're super easy to follow along with, and you can make yourself some really cool stuff for your walls. If you want to be like me, you can put up a few heavy curtains. Don't like that? You can go the acoustic foam route, which is always a great little accent for your walls. Perhaps you're an anime fan. Throw some awesome wall scrolls on the wall, and that will help dampen the sound. Plus, you get to show off a little bit of the awesome artwork. Hey, speaking of artwork, you can hang that on your walls as well. That'll help dampen the sound. Don't have any artwork? Hey, you know what you can do? You can buy one of my pieces. My art would look awesome on your wall. Shameless promotion, and I don't even mind it. Now, if you already have some of these things in place and you still got a lot of echo going on, the biggest contributor of that is generally corners, which I recommend putting up a couple bass traps. Don't like how bass traps look? If you have some extra acoustic foam left over, you can just slam it into the corner and make your own makeshift bass trap. I just gave you a ton of suggestions that'll all work for you, and they're all fairly cheap. In fact, some of the things you probably have around your room, you can use right now if you just want to rearrange it. Shelving that you have in the background or around your stream room, as long as you put it in proper spots and you put on display like your Funkos, your anime statues, your movie memorabilia, any of your collectibles, and you organize it correctly, yeah, all that stuff helps dampen the sound in your room. When you add all these different assets and elements to your streaming room or studio setup, not only are you increasing the cleanness, the richness, and the clarity of your voice, but you're also dampening the sound from escaping from the room that you're in, which means you're not going to be annoying your siblings or your parents or even your neighbors. And that is all good, which is why I really recommend you start adding some dampening assets or elements to your stream room, because it's really, really gonna help. Now, if you need any more help with your audio and specifically your microphone, I'm gonna do you a favor. I'm gonna put a video here up on screen that's gonna show you how to 10x your microphone to really get the most out of it. I really recommend checking that video out at the end of this one. And until next time, all my friends, stay safe, continue to be awesome. Sure, we'll go with that, and of course, peace. God, YouTube send-offs are tough sometimes. Oh, it's all right, we can fix it in post, I think.